friends. Welcome back to my channel and welcome back to another WW Tips Tricks video. I love doing these videos for you guys. They are extremely highly requested. I am all about helping you on your WW or whatever weight loss journey you're on. So today I'm going to share some tips with you on how to bounce back from a gain. What do you do when you step on the scale and either you have a deserved or an undeserved gain? What steps should you take to reset your mindset and also move forward, moving on to a successful next weigh-in? So today I am here to share with you some of my top tips on how to bounce back from a gain. So my first tip is to genuinely reflect on your gain. Think back over the last week or number of days since your last weigh-in and really think about what may have caused the gain. There's typically two things that cause a gain on the scale. Number one is your own doing, and number two is not your own doing. So first, let's talk about your own doing. How was your eating? Did you exercise? Did you stay within your points? Did you make good food choices? Reflect back on what you did to cause the gain on the scale, especially if that gain is definitely positively self-induced. It is something that you did that caused that gain. So think back over the last week. Did you stay on track? Did you track at all? Were you within your points every day? Did you use all of your weeklies? Did you go above your weeklies? What did you do that could have caused that gain on the scale? So really take a good, hard, cold look at yourself and your actions over the last week to figure out exactly what would have caused you to have a gain. Now, on the flip side of that is, what if it's not your own doing? What if you were the perfect Weight Watcher? What if you didn't skip a beat this last week? Your food was on point. Your water was on point. Your exercise was on point. What the heck happened when I stepped on the scale? There could be several reasons why you could see a gain on the scale that was not self-induced. For example, if you are a woman, it could be your time of the month. Our body does crazy things during our time of the month. You can gain several pounds overnight, which clearly isn't actual weight gain, but our body will hold on to water. Our body will hold on to every little bit of salt that we consume when it's our time of the month. So a lot of times you'll see a unsubstantiated gain either the week before, the week of, and sometimes even the week after, because your body is still kind of adjusting to your monthly cycle. So that could definitely be a reason why you could see a gain on the scale that was not self-induced. Another thing could be a change in medication. Did you change a medication recently that has side effects of either water retention or weight gain? That can be something that you have to take for your own health, but can sometimes cause a gain on the scale. And another thing, what about exercise? Did you change up your exercise routine? Did you start an exercise routine? Did you add weightlifting to your routine, or do you feel your muscles are sore? When your muscles are sore, they are retaining fluid. They are rebuilding, they are restructuring. So they are retaining fluid. And I can almost guarantee you, you will see a gain on the scale. It could be simply from changing, starting, or doing just a little bit something different in your exercise routine that causes your muscles to be sore. So definitely reflect on what the gain was from. Was it you or was it not you? My next tip is, think, what could you have done differently, especially if this was a self-induced gain? Could you have tracked your food more efficiently? Could you have maybe changed some of what you ate last week, incorporate a little bit more fresh fruits and vegetables, a little less processed food, a little more water? What could you have done differently that would ultimately have changed your results on the scale when you stepped on? Now, if it's not your own doing, it's a little bit different. You're not gonna not take your medication. You're not gonna not exercise. So sometimes when it isn't your own self-doing, you really couldn't have done a whole lot differently the week before. The only thing that I would suggest that if it isn't self-induced is maybe up your water. Water, as ironic as it sounds, will flush out water retention, will flush out bloat. So that's maybe one thing you could have done if it wasn't your own fault for the gain on the scale. But if it was, you really need to think about A, what you did, and B, what can you do differently so that when you step on the scale the next time, you don't have a gain. You really need to think about and map out what you can do differently for the next time. My next tip is make a game plan for the next week. So now you've reflected on why you had the gain, you're seeing what you can do differently. Now it's time to set all of that reflection and all of that what can I do differently into motion. And that is with a game plan for the next week. Plan your meals, prep your food, pre-track your food, whatever you have to do to ensure that you do not have a gain the next time you weigh in. Now again, this is referencing more of self-induced gain, which, to be honest with you guys, completely honest and transparent, most of the time, I say most of the time, in my opinion, when we step on the scale and we have a gain, it is self-induced. We didn't follow the plan. We were not good Weight Watchers. We ate what we wanted. We drank what we wanted. We didn't exercise. We did not have any water. We had diet soda. We had tea. We had juice. We did not have water. Most of the time when we see a gain, in my opinion, it's self-induced. So that's where we can make a game plan for the next week. Change up the foods that you're eating. Maybe take it easy on the exercise. If you're starting to feel sore, don't overdo it so that your muscles are constantly, constantly, constantly rebuilding. So with this, you can even just take the day off before weigh-in of exercising. Make that one of your rest days so that you're not getting those muscles all tense and broken down before you weigh in. And if it is your own doing, change what you did. Have a game plan. Have a plan for the upcoming week. And I know not all of us are meal preppers. Not all of us want to eat the same food every single day, but that doesn't mean that you can't plan some healthy snacks, even some things that you can throw in your purse or throw in your desk drawer or even throw into your car, weather permitting, of course, that you can have on hand for those times when you don't necessarily have a plan, but you don't want to go off course because you don't want to see a gain on the scale. So set yourself up for success. If you plan, okay, wait, if you fail to plan, you plan to fail. That is definitely something that is taught to us. So set yourself up with a game plan, plan so you can be successful. My next tip is to set a goal. Set a goal for the next week. Now this goal can pertain to food, can pertain to exercise, it can even pertain to what you want to see when you step on the scale the next week. And the best part about setting a goal is writing it down. When you write something down, you are far, far more likely to actually do what you have in your mind. If you write it down, it sticks with you a little bit more and you've written it down. Better yet, post it on social media, share it with a friend, share it with a family member, give yourself some accountability. So if you say, I am going to stay on track every day this next week. I'm gonna have myself 7 blue dots. And you post that on your Facebook, you share that with your best friend or maybe your WW buddy, you are far more likely to stick with it because now not only have you written it down, but you have an accountability. So you are far more likely to stick with your game plan if you write it down. I like to post it on my Facebook group. If you're not part of my Facebook group, I am gonna stick that right here on the screen for you. Definitely join. We have a fantastic group of ladies and men. We have over 3,000 members who are positive, who are here to support you, who you can share your ups, your downs, be your accountability. So write down your goal on the Facebook group. Send it to your best friend. Share it in your WW workshop. Again, you are far more likely to stick with a goal, stick with a plan, if you write it down and you share it. And my last and final, and in my opinion, most important tip I can give you to bounce back from a gain is don't beat yourself up. Whether it was self-induced or not, do not beat yourself up. Do not put yourself into a negative mindset. Give yourself some grace. It's okay. No matter what the gain was, small, large, it doesn't matter. You get a fresh set of points every week. You have a fresh goal every week that you can hit. Get right back on track, but do not beat yourself up. We really, really listen to ourselves. If we are constantly telling ourselves we're a failure or we are a terrible Weight Watcher or we're never gonna lose this weight, guess what, you guys? That's what's gonna happen. So tell yourself something positive. Shift your mindset to positive. Look at all of the weight that I've lost. I've lost 10 pounds, 20 pounds, 50 pounds, 100 pounds. Reflect back on what you've done that's positive. Reflect back on what you did that was negative and turn it into something positive. Don't beat yourself up, you guys. It is a gain. It is not the end of the world. There are far worse things that can happen to us as human beings. So just don't beat yourself up. Offer yourself a little bit of grace. Start fresh on the new week. In fact, start fresh right now. Start fresh tomorrow. Just because you blew it on the scale doesn't mean that you have to continue into that downward spiral. Start fresh and give yourself some grace. Think positive. Put yourself in a positive place, and I promise you, you will see positive results on the scale. Thank you so much for joining me in this video. I hope that I offered you some valuable tips that can help you bounce back from a gain. Again, you guys, it's not the end of the world. Start over, start fresh, follow these tips that I shared with you, and I promise that you will see the results that you want on the scale. It may not be immediate, but you stick with it and you keep positive and you will see the results. Thank you again so much for watching. If you're new to my channel, I'd like to welcome you. Make sure that you are subscribing. If you hit that little notification bell, YouTube will notify you every time that I upload a new video. That way you don't miss out. We have a lot of fun around here. We have meal preps. We have what I eat in a days. Weigh-in videos, lots of fun recipe videos. My channel is really, really consumed with recipes. So if you're looking for tips, tricks, and recipes to be successful on WW, you have come to the right place. Give this video a thumbs up. Comment down below. Let me know what you guys think of my tips. And also, if you have some additional tips that you can share, we're all in this together, you guys. We're all a team. Share those tips down in the comments so that our fellow WW, our fellow weight loss journey people, our peeps, can see your tips as well. Again, thank you for watching. I love you guys so much, and I'll see you all in the next one. Bye, guys.